For many of us, coffee is a lifeline. But here at Queen City Grounds, you could say it's more of an art form or trade. This is a must stop for coffee lovers. Let me take you inside.
When we started this, we wanted to have a small corner coffee shop. And it kind of steamrolled. And it turned into something much bigger.
Queen City Grounds has maintained that friendly neighborhood coffee shop feel. But owner Adam Hummel is right. It's so much more than that. I mean, have you been to a coffee shop that sprinkles a picture of Will Smith on top of your drink? I didn't think so.
So yeah, we want people to be comfortable, to have fun. It's not a stuffy place at all. And yeah, we just want you to keep coming back.
Have good coffee.
Have good coffee. Have good food.
Queen City Grounds is just about 1 year old. Adam's brother-in-law had been wanting to start a coffee shop, so that's what they did.
You know, I just said, all right, well, let's do it. You know, let's see what happens. The first question that you have to ask is, well, where do we get our coffee from? And I had a friend that I grew up with named Paul Wagner. Turned out he was like this world rock star. In fact, Grammy nominated in 2019. He's just an incredible guitarist for a band from the Carolinas, actually. But I knew that he also was doing coffee roasting.
Talk about a man of many talents. Adam got Paul on board. One thing led to another, and Paul, his roaster, and his roasting business moved right into the shop.
So he's your roaster?
He is our roaster.
He's your guy?
He is our guy. We don't get coffee from anywhere else.
So, of course, we had to meet Paul.
I got into it really through my other career as a musician, just traveling the world and kind of discovering coffee as a way to pass the time, really.
Tell me how it works.
It's basically a pretty simple machine. We take green coffee, which is really the seed of a cherry. It's kind of like a little pebble. We load them into this hopper. It's kind of like cooking, you know. We change the temp and we'll adjust the airflow when there's some smoke created from the roasting process to sort of suck all the smoke out. And then when it's ready, we dump them into the cooling tray. This kind of stirs them around and also sucks air through the beans to cool them down relatively quickly. All the potential of the coffee is in that green seed.
Yeah.
So what we're trying to do when we roast it is basically not screw it up.
Adam says it's important that they know where the coffee comes from the farmer to the buyer to the roaster.
I've had people to tell me, you know, that we have ruined their, you know, their coffee habit because, you know, they're used to going to, you know, the grocery store and buying some off the wall bag of coffee. But when they come here, they can clearly taste the difference.
Besides the quality cup of joe, they serve food by salute, have coffee tastings every Wednesday afternoon, trivia on Friday nights, and paint and sip on Saturday nights. And the sky's the limit.
We want this to be a community place and let the people make it what it's eventually going to be.